Hello, my name is Keshwani. That's K-E-S-H-W-A-N-I, Keshwani. We are here because we want to prepare for the HESI. Right now, we are in the process of learning our vocabulary words from chapter 3 of this book here, the HESI Admission Assessment Exam Review, the third edition. If you do not own this book already, purchase one immediately. You're going to need it. Like I said, we are in the process of learning our vocabulary words that you will find in chapter number 3 on page number 48. Before we get going and before I forget it, in the event, since you are preparing for the HESI, in the event that you need help also with the math portion of the exam, we have already solved every single math problem that you can find in this book, and you will find all of those lessons, there are 50 of them, you will find all of those lessons from day number 1 to 50. Just type in HESI, math, day 1 through 50. In the event that you need more help, the math on the T's is very similar to what you will encounter on HESI, and there are 80 videos in that series. T's math, day 1 through 80. Let's pick up from where we left off. Today is our lesson number 6. The very first word we're going to learn today is How do we pronounce it? Compensatory. Compensatory. What does it mean? Compensatory is an adjective. Compensatory obviously comes from the word compensate. It means something done to compensate for something else. Something that is done as a compensation to compensate for something else that you've done. Something that offsets something else. Something that is done to make up for something else. And the word is compensatory. So if you did something wrong and you want to make up for that wrongdoing, you want to do something to make up for it, you would say that the act was compensatory. Comes from the word compensate, as we said, and the noun compensate would be the word. Compensate would be the word, which is compensate. And the noun would be compensation. Compensation is the noun. Let's move on then to the next one. As I pointed out to you in the first day of the vocabulary lessons, that these words are arranged alphabetically. And therefore, there is no rhythm or rhyme from one word to the next. There is no confluence of idea. There is no confluence of thoughts. They're alphabetically arranged. Comply is the next word. Comply, which is a verb. What does it mean to comply? To comply means to do. As you are told. If you're given certain orders, if you're given certain directions, if you're given certain instructions, and if you follow those instructions, those orders, you're complying. One is complying. It is an act to act in accordance with rules, commands, requests, orders, or wishes. If you act in accordance with someone's rules, someone's commands, someone's requests, someone's wishes, you're complying. And the one who complies is said to be compliant. 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 The noun would be compliance. Noun would be compliance, which just means act of complying. One who complies is said to be compliant. Person who is willing to comply. Compliant means one who is willing to comply. One who is willing to follow orders. Someone who is willing to follow the directions, the wishes of some other person. Mike is compliant. That means Mike will do what he's told. On the other hand, if he said that he was given certain rules to adhere to, but he was not compliant. Mike was given certain rules, certain orders, certain directions to comply with, but we found out that he was not compliant. He did not adhere to those rules, so we had to let him go. He wasn't doing what he was told. He was not compliant. Let's move on then. Next one. 27. As you can tell, these are all simple, straightforward words. But they are there, so we have to talk about them. Concave. 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 That's the E. Concave versus convex. What does it mean for something to be concave or something to be convex? It appears in the context of lenses. In the medical field, you will come across different instruments where you will have to deal with different nature of glasses and mirrors in the microscope or whatever, what have you. And one comes across these terms, concave and convex. Concave means rounded. Rounded inward, and of course this one means rounded outward. Now how do we go about keeping the two separate? Do we have a mnemonic? Do we have a mnemonic device to keep them separate, one from the other, concave and convex? Well, the mnemonic that I use is very simple. This is rounded inward, so here if you have a mirror, this is the part where you see the reflection. This is where the light is going to be reflected. And to me, if you look inside, see, if I look inside, to me, looks like a cave, concave. And this, the mirror is on the outside. The glass where the light is reflected is on the outside. It's convex. This is concave. You have to look. The light goes in. See? It's like that. It looks like a cave. Concave. Convex. Let's keep on going. concise, which means to be brief and clear, to be brief and clear, concise, or to be succinct. To be succinct, if you give a succinct answer, means that your answer was brief, but at the same time it was clear, it was lucid, people had no trouble understanding it. It was brief and it was clear, it was lucid. Lucid means to be clear. The noun of clear is clarity, the noun of lucid would be lucidity. It has lucidity. Your answer was brief, even though it was brief, it had clarity, it had lucidity. Such an answer is said to be a very concise, very succinct answer. Very succinct answer. Well, clarity has to do more with being succinct. Concise just means to be brief, do you understand? The antonym of concise would be what? Of course, antonym would have to mean something that is very wordy, something that uses a lot of words. If someone always gives answer, very long-winded answer using too many words, then the term that we employ to describe such a scenario is verbose. Which is also an adjective. Verbose means to be wordy. To be wordy, verbose. And the noun of verbose is? You know the noun of verbose? The noun of verbose is verbosity. Noun of verbose is verbosity. What I'm going to do here right now is to give you a few more words. Just be patient and I'll tell you where I'm going with this. Vocabulary. Day 16. First word we already came across, succinct. Curt. Terse. Laconic. And brevity. All of these words that you see on the blackboard, succinct, curt, terse, laconic, brevity, they all have to do with using few words, not using too many words. But the differences in the meanings of these words lie in their nuances. The differences in the meanings of these words lie in the nuances. In other words, giving a laconic answer is not same as being curt. There is certain nuance to the meaning curt, to the word curt. There are certain nuance to the meaning of succinct. As we just said, succinct, concise just means to be brief. But succinct has an additional nuance of being lucid, being clear. If you give me a very brief answer, it was a very brief answer, but I have no idea what the hell you're talking about. It was a concise answer, but I have no idea what you just said. That's not being lucid, that's not being clear. On the other hand, if you say something that is very brief and yet the audience understood it without any trouble, well, that's a very good quality. And that's called succinct. That answer was very succinct. It was very clear, it was very lucid, and at the same time, you didn't use a lot of words. Whereas curt and terse have some additional nuances. We won't go there right now. Laconic means also the same thing, and brevity. If you're curious, as I said, I'm not going to tell you right now because otherwise it will take too long. If you're curious, if you want to learn these words and their nuances, the minute differences, the subtle differences in the meanings of these words, vocabulary day number 16. In addition to this vocabulary series that you're watching, which deals with the words that you find in the Hesse book, there is an additional vocabulary series at my channel. Just simply type in vocabulary words, day 16, it will pop right up. It doesn't matter which exam you're preparing for. Just type in GRE vocabulary words, or GMAT vocabulary words, or HESI vocabulary, T's vocabulary, SAT, ACT. Type in anything you like, the name of the test, along with the vocabulary words, and then day number, the video will pop right up. In day number 16, we learn all of these words. I would like you to learn these words. These are good words to know. Let's go on then. These are good words to know, just There's a good word to know, not just for the exam, not just for the HESI, but in general, in life in general. Do you understand? Consistent. There is a difference between opening your mouth and coming across as a five-year-old because your vocabulary is so simple, and opening your mouth and coming across as a grown person, as an adult, as an educated person. And that has a great deal to do with your command of the grammar, your command of the vocabulary. Do you understand? Consistent. Consistent. Very simple word, it's an adjective, which just means something that is in agreement. Something that is in agreement. Something that is compatible. Something that conforms. Something that conforms a given set of rules or regulations. Something that follows a given set of rules or regulations, from something that conforms to those rules or regulation, is said to be consistent. Something that is in agreement, something that is compatible. Yesterday you told me this, this, and this, but just now I spoke with Michael and he gave me a different story. What you told me yesterday doesn't seem to be compatible, doesn't seem to be compatible with what I heard from everybody else in the department. You're not telling me the truth. Your story is not consistent with what I observed. Your story is not consistent with what I heard from the other three people. Something is not right. It's not adding up. It's not compatible. It's not consistent. The noun of consistent would be consistency. Now what we need to understand here is that these words that we are doing right now, of course they appear in this book here, in HESI. So these words are not used just as words that you and I use in our daily life, in our daily language, but these words of course have a great deal to do with medical profession. So after all, it's for medical field. In the medical field, the word consistency, it's not just a noun of consistent as in being compatible, being in agreement. This word has a different meaning when doctors and nurses talk about some fluid not having a proper consistency. It has a different meaning. Let's learn that meaning, shall we? So consistency in that context, in the context of some medical fluid that you're about to give to patient and you find that it's not of the right consistency, it doesn't look right, it doesn't look like of a right consistency, in that context it means degree of viscosity. Degree of viscosity, which simply means how thin or thick given fluid is. Whatever the fluid might be, how thin or thick a given fluid is. And the word is viscosity. And viscosity, of course, comes from the word so this was 29, and viscosity comes from the word viscous. It's an adjective, viscous, which means the resistance that a given fluid has in terms of flowing. A liquid that has high resistance to the flow. A liquid that has high resistance to flow is said to be viscous. It's said to be viscous because it has high viscosity, because it has high viscosity. Oil that you put in your engine oil, is very viscous. If you were to pour it on the ground, it doesn't flow very fast. It's going to flow, but very, very slowly. On the other hand, if you pour a glass of water on the floor, well, it's going to flow very quickly. It's going to spread out very quickly. It's going to spread out very quickly because water has low viscosity. Water has low viscosity. I don't know how to spell viscosity. We just did it. Oil, on the other hand, is very viscous. Oil has high viscosity. Oil has high viscosity. Water has low viscosity. And that's where the word consistency comes in. That's why the word consistent is in this book, because we were not interested in the word consistent by itself. We were interested in the noun of the word consistence, which is consistency. And I mean, when we talk about the word, when we talk about the consistency of a given fluid, we're talking about their viscosity. How viscous is it? How thick is it? And so on and so forth. That was the end for today. I'll see you tomorrow, okay? Bye now.